What's up, guys? The Flyin Tech here, and today we're going to be replacing the R9DS receiver in the Loki-X3 by Storm. So let's get right into it. Alright guys, for this repair, you're going to need the RDS receiver, a pair of needle nose pliers, some solder, a soldering iron, a screwdriver with a Torx head, and of course the Loki. Alright guys, the first thing you want to do is turn on your soldering iron, get it good and hot. Alright guys, so while the soldering iron's heating up, you can take apart your Loki. Make sure to keep all screws in a safe place so you don't lose them. Once you take the Loki apart, make sure to take note of where the wires are connected to the receiver. Black is on the left, red in the middle, white on the far right. Next, you're going to take the housing off your R9DS. To do this, you want to pry off the bottom. Simply take your pliers and carefully pry the bottom off. Just like that. After that, you should be able to simply lift up the board and pull it out. All right, once you've got the board out, what you want to go ahead and do is remove all of these pins. All of them are completely useless to this application, so we're going to have to take them off, unfortunately. You want to simply grab your soldering iron and start heating up the pad. And that's it. Comes right off. Clean up any areas that may have gotten together. Simple like that. Make sure to keep your soldering iron clean. Guys, it's real important that you separate these. You do not want them touching. All right, now we're gonna go back to the Loki. And you're gonna size it up here. As you can see, we're gonna be using these three pins right here. 1, 2, and 3. And remember again, black on the far left, red in the middle, white to the far right, okay? So let's go ahead and do them one by one. All right, guys, we're gonna remove the plug now so that we can work with it a little more intimately. Bring over my helping hands. All right, guys, now we're gonna solder it to the receiver. I've got my helping hands here giving me a hand. Okay, we'll start with the white wire here. White to the far right. Next up, we've got the red in the middle. And the black on the left. Next, what I like to do is put a little bit of black tape around it, just so that nothing shorts out. All right, let's put it back in the Loki. Okay. Make sure the antenna's facing up. Like so. So I've got the TX here. I got a battery. Let's plug it in. First things first, let's see if she even powers on. Okay. That's always a good sign. All right, excellent. No smoke. All right, so now to bind, you're gonna find the little button right here on the side, which I covered like an idiot. Guys, don't make a rookie mistake like me and cover your bind button when you're taping it up. You know, they always make this fun. You're gonna go ahead and hold down your bind button, plug in your, plug everything in. Okay, we're in bind mode now. You can see it's flashing. We're gonna go ahead, turn on the TX. And that's it, she's bound. One more thing to note is you wanna tap this little button twice so that it makes the light, the LED, go from orange to white, blue. That's gonna put it into the mode that will work with your RadioLink AT9. All right, let's connect it to Betaflight and see how she does.
Heading establish a connection. As you can see, the quad is here.
But let's check out that receiver. All right, I'm going to turn the receiver on. Receiver is now on. And there you have it. Everything works as it should. Excellent. All right, guys, that's it for me. Hope you enjoyed. If you did, please leave a thumbs up. Leave comments below. Don't forget to subscribe, and we'll catch you on the next one. Happy flying.